big and aesthetic back.
I took the Billy Coop back, then I hopped in the car. I put the bitch in the front of the Billy in front of the driver. And man, the shit that it weedy can't smoke in the road. Right, wow, wow. I stepped up and cut up, I'm drinking, I shoot off the tires. I'm
in a coop by myself. We got some new products from Gorilla coming out. Gorilla's got a new product coming out every week, but these are really good. You're sweating a lot, there's hella sodium in these. So we're gonna run one of these today for today's back workout. We're gonna do a scoop of Gorilla Mode energy with that. Don't need too much. It's the afternoon, guys. We're here at Gym 1 at Alpha. I'm gonna run y'all through a back and biceps workout. Every movement, I wanna run you guys how I'm doing it, how to use the equipment, give y'all a few tips on how to better the movement. I'm about 3 weeks post-show. Training has not been super consistent, but I'm ready to get back into it now, hit my routine hard, get back to my six-day split. Y'all already know I'm running push-pull leg, so without further ado, let's get into it. Before every single workout, I tell all my clients to do this. Do 3 sets of bar hangs. I'll do it for about 25, 30 seconds. Really just hang your body, like dead weight for the bar. Other than those bar hangs, I don't keep it too crazy when it comes to warming up. The best warm-up routine is the one that works for you. So whatever makes you feel the best going into your workout, do that. For me, it's really warming up my shoulders. So I'll do some rotations like these. Other than that, pretty much do the same thing with a resistance band. I'll grab one of these thick ones. They got these here all over the gym at Alpha Land. Pretty much do the same thing, some rotations. Some reverse dislocations, and I'll grab the band in the middle and just pull it apart and make sure my rotator cuffs are warmed up. Okay, first movement. I do this every single back day. We're just gonna start out with 3 sets of pull-ups, about 8 to 10 reps of quality reps. Don't just bang through them. Make sure you get full range of motion, extend your arms completely, getting a good contraction. I'm not gonna lie, if there's any movement you wanna stick with to grow your back, increase your strength, grow in size, guys, do pull-ups. This will change the game for your back day. If you can't do a normal pull-up, use assistance. As you'll see by this machine, we can add some resistance to it. It's gonna help pull us up. So if you can't do a successful pull-up, that's totally fine. Just make sure you got some equipment available to help you out. Other option, if you don't have one of these machines available, literally just put one of these resistance bands on the pull-up bar and put your feet in it, like this. We got pull-ups out of the way. Second exercise, we're gonna do this seated row. I really like this. So since pull-up, we targeted width, going for wider lats. That movement's really gonna help with giving us some more width to our lats. This is gonna help with some thickness, which is what I need with my back. I have a wide back, but I need to work on density. So this, we're gonna do a close grip, and we're gonna squeeze for 2 seconds at the top of the movement. 3 sets, 8 to 10 quality reps.
Head off, I commanded him. I'm from the bando, my daddy had abandoned me. Bando, mama tried to cover up and bandage me. Mama, I'm the first one to lead a whole legacy.
Holding for those 2 seconds at the top of the movement is really gonna help us increase that time under tension. I'll see a lot of people come in here, and I used to do this when I was in like high school. Literally start yanking the weight back and forth and not getting in any quality reps. While it might feel like you're getting the work in, your reps could be so much more quality if you just focus, take a little bit more time to slow down your reps. So I'd say hold for 2 seconds at the top and go back for 3 seconds. So think in your mind, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. It's gonna be about 5 seconds per rep. You wanna increase that time under tension for a bigger back. Third movement, guys, we're gonna go in the other direction this time and focus more on width again. So guys, cable lat pullover. So think about, instead of pulling the weight with your arms, which it might look like I'm pulling with my arms, pull with your back, pull with your lats. Watch. Don't keep your arms fully bent. Keep a slight bend in there. Grab the bottom of the rope, thumbs up. Take a couple steps back and pull the weight back to your waist. Right about the belly button area with your back. Watch this. Try to think about not pulling with your arms. It's gonna feel like you need to pull with your arms, but trust me, pull with your lats. I'm feeling good. I've not been a full week. of training since my show. So it feels good to have a nice back day. I probably only hit back maybe twice since I competed. Next video, we're gonna be running legs, guys. I've not hit legs in probably 3.5 weeks. We're gonna be doing 2 bicep workouts. First one, we're gonna do alternating dumbbell hammer curls. Probably one of my favorite movements for bis. Guys, I used to hit arms every day. I don't do that now, just twice per week now. As far as sets and reps, we're gonna do 3 sets. I wanna do a little bit more volume with these, so we're thinking 10 to 12 reps per arm. Make sure these are slow and controlled, but also make sure you're getting all of your reps in.
Get behind me, I lose them. They tryna guess what I'm doing. They tryna guess who I'm screwing. They ain't even they business. They ain't want
to. That felt pretty heavy for guys. For arms, I'm all about volume. If you really push the volume, 1 to 2 movements is all you really need per workout. You don't need to be spending 30, 45 minutes blasting hundreds of sets of arms. Not needed. When my mom got me my first gym membership in 7th grade, I grabbed a dumbbell, I put it on the floor, and I just started yanking it, right? 24 years old now, and I'm still doing the same damn thing. So, we're gonna do some single arm alternating dumbbell rows. 8 to 10 reps per arm, slow and controlled reps. Y'all know the drill.
Nothing new under the sun, nobody fucking with sun. I got a couple of sons, a couple of guns, a couple of niggas that bust up the party and fuck up the fun. She digging me and I'm cuffing a friend. She igging you, are we fucking for fun? I got a suck in the thumb, that my little baby. She call me daddy like grandma.
The number one thing I want to tell you all this is don't pick the weight up. You're not moving like this. You're not doing anything. Guys, pull with your lats. Think about pulling the weight in a diagonal line. Pull the weight with your lat. Think about pulling it back. Otherwise, all you're doing is moving the weight up and down. You're not doing nothing. Pull the weight. Get a good mind-muscle connection. We're good to go. A lot of people will kind of put their knee on a bench and do these. It's all preference. For me, I like to stand up, put my hand on something in front of me like this to use as a support. But if you prefer just going on the bench, that's fine. It's all up to you. Last movement. I'm exhausted. I'm having a really good workout. This is one of those machines I'm insanely good at. I can't bench press a whole lot. I used to before I tore my shoulder. I can't squat a whole lot. I can't do a lot of movements a whole lot, but this thing I can do a whole lot. So I'm gonna put this thing on 130. Get about 10 to 12 quality reps. Go hard on these. 2 really quality sets. That's gonna finish up the workout.
Yeah, and he shook. Please don't let them fool ya. I don't care how they look. Heard all of the talking, now it's quiet, now it's shush. 29 is coming, they on edge when I cook. Lead the league in scoring, man, but look at my assist. Yes, I be with Future, but I like to reminisce. I do not forget a thing, I'm patient, it's a gift. Try to tell them.
I cannot finish that last set. I just did a burnout that last set. That's gonna be it for the workout, guys. That's definitely been my best workout since my show. I'm really glad I did this today. I just wanna show more of you guys, more so the training side of my life, how I'm doing these exercises, how I've built my physique, and showing you guys the whole journey. So if y'all want more of these videos, let me know. We can do it for chest days. We'll do a leg day next. That'll be fun. A huge shout out to Elias behind the camera for putting together this whole video. Hope y'all enjoyed. Code Ogle, all athlete and gorilla mind. If y'all ever run up my code, screenshot the order, DM it to me on Instagram. Instagram's gonna be linked down below in the description, along with all my links. But thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below what you guys want to see in the next one. That'll be it for this week, guys. Peace out.